product designer Max McMurdo, who gave up a career designing cars to pursue his upcycling passion.
I'm going to keep it very traditional on the outside, with just a hint of what's within, by putting three little handles on the front in brass, but they're going to be toy cars painted brass.
Right.
Because when you open the door, the madness begins. There'll be a little pull-out drawer here, there'll be a racetrack, toy cars, sorts of things. Just the ultimate in cool play areas from
either. You didn't have one of these when you were younger, did you?
I had a shoebox. Jake, would you like to come downstairs? We've got a surprise for you. This cupboard isn't a normal cupboard. Are you ready?
Closet.
This is your garage for all your toy cars.
It's good.
It's good. I'm glad it's good. Smell it again.
Yeah.
Oh, we're through.
Well,
thank goodness for that. Oh my goodness, I think they've got so hot they've welded themselves together. No, that wasn't part of the plan. Scott, this is your job. Because when I think of you, I think of glamour.
And then you produce a palette.
A palette, yeah, I think, yeah. You palettes can be beautiful, honestly. So I'd like you to delicately-ish remove this wood. It's going to split at the ends, because it always kind of does.
Yeah.
Hit that on there, have some fun. Have you got a quiet hammer you can use?
Thank you very much indeed. I'm actually not going to do any more.
I guess the great thing about this is you could just continue onwards and upwards, make it as big as you want. It could even grow with your book collection as you get more and more books. Now, I want to create something that leans, so it's structurally sound and even utilises the corner of their kitchen, which is a really awkward space. I'm going to create it using this old scaffold board because it looks really cool. Got to tweak this angle, just want it to lean enough to keep the weight into the corner for safety, but at the same time, don't want a massive footprint jolting out into the room.
Very clever again. All right, you've done it again. I love it.
One of my favourite things I've ever made was that coat hanger lampshade, and I just can't wait to see it in situ. That is brilliant. I'm going to make a pair of beautiful dining chairs out of scaffold boards that, when they're not in use, slot together to create a really stunning coffee table.
OK, so this is great.
But where do you store these chairs when the dining table that Nessa's made is in the small mode? I shall show you.
Oh, I know what you're going to do now. You are a clever small person.
They become a coffee table.
That is amazing. You are so pleased with yourself, aren't you?
I am, can you tell? We're going to give this to Ryan as a desk. Ryan's really into bicycles, so these are going to be two bicycle wheels. Ryan's going to put his bike onto this racing handlebars. Yeah. The desk itself has a hinge here. It's going to lift his bike, so it's mounted on the wall, on the back of the desk.
Then what you do is you've then got a desk against the wall that you can use, but then you're looking up at your bike the whole time.
Yes.
That's incredible.
That's amazing.
My heart's beating quite fast just at the thought of having to make this now.
Oh, look at that.
So imagine the bike is now being lifted. The bike is staying vertical. The bike is here.
Done it again.
The bike is here. The bike is now falling. Wheel of the bike there and there. And now you sit in this direction.
That direction.
Kate asked Max to upcycle her late father's table, so it's been sanded, waxed, and painted. It's of huge sentimental value, but will Kate approve?
That looks slightly different.
In a good way, I hope.
Yeah.
I like it.
Yeah, I really like it. I really like it.
I'm glad.
I'm so relieved.
Yeah.
I actually couldn't sleep last night because of that table. So nervous.
That table is over 30 years old. It's beautiful. It's actually a really beautiful piece.
Good, I'm glad.